Now let's look at the buffer in distribution system. Let's say, first of all, in distribution system, we don't have time buffers. We have inventory buffers. Physical inventory is required at the retail, at the distribution center, warehouses, and all that. But why do we need inventory? Supposing you go to a shop and demand a loaf of bread or a soap or a toothpaste, how long are you willing to wait? If the shop owner says, look, I'm noting down your order, you want this of a toothpaste or something, I'll send it to the manufacturer, he'll manufacture it, he'll send it to me, then I will deliver it to you. Will you like that? So you said your tolerance time for certain things is almost zero. You're not even willing to wait for 5 minutes. You go to the shop and you want to get it. So it is the customer tolerance time that decides whether we want to keep inventory or not. Why I'm highlighting that? Because nowadays it has become fashionable to say inventory is a liability, it is not an asset. Well, it is a liability under certain cases, but still we do inventory. Why do we need it? Because the customer tolerance time would be zero, or it could be far less than the production lead time. The customer lead time, that is CTT, as we abbreviated, is the time that the customer is willing to wait to receive the product after placing an order. If the customer tolerance time is more than production lead time, customer tolerance time more meaning is willing to wait and wait for more time than what you really would take to produce. Well, we don't need to hold any inventory. If he's giving you the order, I will take it. He says, fine, no problem. Great. Then you don't really need to hold any inventory. But if it is shorter than production lead time, we need to keep inventory of finished goods. If production lead time is, say, 10 days, and customer, when he places the order, he wants it in 2 days, you have to keep the order. And if it is zero, customer tolerance time is zero, meaning he wants an immediate delivery, then you have to keep the inventory somewhat more than the production lead time. So how do you calculate how much inventory is needed? Production lead time minus the customer tolerance time. But there are some other factors also. So let's look at them very quickly. If you are an owner of a retail store, there is always a question in front of you. How much inventory should I hold in my retail store? Now, supposing I give you a situation that there is a demand for product X in the market and you want to sell it. However, the customers need it immediately when they come to buy. So their tolerance time is zero. So it means obviously you need to keep enough inventory, keep enough stock. As you look at the supply side, the factory from which you are buying it, they say that we take on an average 1 month to deliver the product to you. On an average 1 month. So how much inventory will you keep so that you can deliver the product to your customer when they ask for it? The answer is very obvious. You will say that if resupply is going to take 1 month, on an average 1 month, and customer wants it immediately, I will keep 1 month inventory. Fair, simple answer, very obvious answer. But then you need some more inventory on the way. Some should be coming on the way because it takes so much time from placing the order and receiving it. When the factory tells you that we will supply you the material after 1 month, so on an average 1 month, it means if you place an order today, about an average 1 month will deliver. So we need something on the way already. Well, in that case, you need some more inventory. So how much inventory you will keep? Maybe another month's inventory on the way. So 1 month in you will keep 2 months inventory, 1 month inventory in your hand, and 1 month inventory on the way. So 2 months inventory, we are fine. So you'll feel that fine. Now you can service your customer. Let them come anytime, ask for that product, and I'll be able to give. But what does average 1 month mean? This term average is the something very, very bad thing, that average. You know, I really hate it. Simple example. Supposing I want to cross a river and I don't know swimming. So I'll have to walk through it. There's no boat, nothing. So I ask the question, how much is the depth? And you tell me that the average depth is four feet. No, I'm 5 feet, 5 inches tall. Average depth is 4 feet. Even though I don't know how to swim, I can walk through. Can I really? I'm certain to get drowned because this is average 4 feet. So somewhere it is much more than 6 feet, 7 feet. So if I reach that place, finished. So similarly, in our business also, it is not exact 1 month. It is, there's a variation. Sometimes it may take less. You might receive it earlier than 1 month. But sometime it will take more than 1 month. Also, if the factory has some other urgent orders, they may delay your order. Not intentionally, but they have to. So what happens if it takes more than a month to receive the product? Suppose it takes 2 months. If your customers come, you will be unable to service them. Right? So what do you do? Also, it happens that it is not that customer will always buy a standard quantity. Sometimes they will demand more than what they asked for the last time. So if they ask for more quantity, well, your stocks will get over, the customer service will be jeopardized, and you might lose the business because they will go away. They may not come back to you again. So what do you propose to protect yourself? Well, you will think obviously that you will want to keep 2 months inventory in hand. So let there be any delay from the factory, you have enough thing. And also the other side of it, that 2 months inventory is on the way. So on one side I'm selling, other side the material keeps coming in. Well, it doesn't sound to be a great idea, 2 months inventory in hand, 2 months on the way, but you are willing to do to protect your sales. So you will keep 4 months inventory. But what about transportation? Have you thought of that? It is not uncommon to see that the transport is not available when it is needed. Or a truck carrying the product, you get stuck somewhere on the way, or it's simply late. So that will jeopardize your customer service. And you don't want to do that. You will want to be paranoid, absolutely paranoid, and will keep 3 months inventory in your hand and 3 months inventory on the way. 6 months inventory, what an investment. I think you are going mad. And what if the life of the product is 6 months or less? No, that you don't want that kind of situation. And we talked only about one product. You are selling hundreds of products. So for all those products, are you going to hold 6 months inventory? Come on, you are not out of your mind as yet, right? The point is, you may not be that paranoid. Nevertheless, you will have enough buffer, say between 2 to 6 months inventory, depending for different products, depending upon the supply situation and how paranoid you want to get and all that. But still, you will have a lot of inventory that is in order to meet your requirement of servicing your customer whenever they come and demand. So how do we manage these buffers in this? Okay. It is difficult to measure the buffer in terms of time in the distribution system. So at best, we say that we hold 10 days inventory and 10 days of sale. When you say we hold 10 days inventory. So how do we go about using buffer that we keep? Maybe 10 days, maybe 1 month inventory, or maybe 6 months inventory. Let's see. Again, we do the same thing. We decide how much inventory we want to keep. Again, how do we decide it? We implement TOC's solution, replenishment solution for this purpose, wherein we are able to bring down the need to keep huge quantity of finished goods at retail source as well as with the distributors and warehouse. So whatever we decide, come on, we have decided that we want to keep the 100 units of one particular product at a retail store. Now, what does that mean? What do we do with that? Same thing. That is the buffer, divide it into three equal parts and call them green, red, and yellow. Now, what is this green? Green, if you have say quantity. So for okay, let us take one this example. That's one item we decided to have say 100 units in our stock. So it so the if we apply this logic, we will say that if our stock is between 66 to 100, because continuously we are selling that, so it will keep going down. So it we if we have the stock between 66 to 100, we are in green. If our stock level of inventory falls below 66, but it is still above 33, if the level of inventory, because we are continuously selling the product, falls below 66 and still it is above 33, we say we are okay, we are in yellow zone. But if it goes down below 33, then we say that we are in red zone, we are not okay, we may have to take some action. No, so the same concept of green, yellow, red is used in all the three applications. For manufacturing, it is a time to complete the order. Okay, it is the entire your lead time which is cut into half. For projects, it is not the entire lead time. We have the minimum time required for a task. Take out the buffer, cut that into half. It is that, and that is divided into three. Whereas in distribution, it is inventory that we decide to keep, and that we divide it into three parts. And let us now explore how we are going to make use of this. Typically, what happens in any retail or warehouse or distributor? You have some quantity with you. When sales happen, that quantity goes down. If you see the chart, it has gone down from 66% to almost 33%. Then you receive the material from the manufacturer or from the distributor. So you go back to almost 75-80%. So you go back to green zone. Then again, there is a lot of sale. So you sell so much that your stock level, inventory level falls below 33%. So you get into red zone. Again, there is some resupply, again there is sale, again there is a supply, again there is sale. So it keeps on going up and down, up and down, up and down all the time. This does not happen in manufacturing. But similar thing happens in projects where the buffer goes up and down continuously. But in the distribution, it happens more drastically. No? So what? If we have this, okay, understood. So what? So how do we manage the buffers level of how do we manage the level of inventory? From time to time, we need to take decisions regarding increasing or decreasing the buffer. Like, come on, why? We have set one level, we want to be with that, static. No, I said no. From time to time, you need to take decisions whether to increase the buffer level or to reduce it. Your business situation is dynamic, and several things can happen. Market demand may go up or down. You may anticipate a start or end of a season. If you particularly when you are dealing in the fashion industry, start and end of the season is very important. You have to be there in the market when the season starts, and when the season ends, you should have very less or no inventory of that particular variety. Also, if you have implemented TOC solution, your replenishment time goes down very significantly. And when it happens again and again, it will keep on going down. So again, you may have to change the level of your buffer or your target quantity that you may get. Then you may introduce some new products or new model or discontinue the old ones, or you may acquire new customers so their demand is going up, or spread the business to new territories so there are new there are more retailers, so there could be more distributors, so you need to produce more and so on. So there are several reasons that forces you to change your buffer level. So how do you decide? What is the rule for that? We'll see that. How do you use the buffer which is constantly fluctuating? Let us first understand that. See, we have seen here that when you sail it, it goes down. It may go down from green to yellow or yellow to red. When you receive the products from the distributor, again it may go back to yellow or green. Again you sell, so again it will go down. Again you receive something, again it will go up. So how do what do we do? See, this buffer management frequently checks the selling rate and replenishment rate of each product. If the selling rate becomes faster than the replenishment rate, a warning signal is raised so as to minimize the risk of losing the sale. What does it mean? If you are if you are able to sell much more, and from green you get into yellow, from yellow your stock goes down below 33% and it is nearing zero. So if it hits zero, and if some customers come, you will not be able to sell, right? So you lose the sale. So there's a risk. So you have to receive the resupply before it goes into zero. So that rates are constantly checked. Again, not by human beings. We are in computer world, so there are lots of applications which do it and give it to you on platter. That look, here you need to pay attention. Now the other thing also may happen. Some, you know, your sales may fall. It's not that all the time your sales will increase. So you will have more and more materials getting into green zone. So you are likely to have surplus quantity, or your products might have become obsolete. As long as there is some predetermined proportion of buffer remaining and a predetermined buffer level is assumed to be okay. So if it is somewhere in the middle that it keeps on going to green, comes down to yellow, or then when it's sold, okay, it goes down to red, again comes back. So then it is considered to be okay. So this buffer, we say that buffer management in distribution seeks answers to two questions. One is, when should I expedite? And second one is, when should I change the buffer size? The first question, now by now you know, when you are in red zone, what you will do? First of all, will you bother if you have enough stock that is there in green zone? Will not bother. If you have your stock level is in yellow, okay, you need not bother. When it is in red, what you will do? You will look at when the next consignment is coming. It is due shortly before you exhaust your stock, or you will see that if somebody is already on the way and it is likely to come. If the answers are yes, then you don't need to take any action. But if you don't find material on the way, or you don't see any schedule of dispatch, then you have to expedite. Now, how many such orders, how many such products that you may have to expedite? Most of the orders, most of the products will remain in green or yellow. Some products might reach in red. So those orders you need to pay attention. Out of that, some orders you might have to expedite if the system has not worked somewhere. By default, something must be there on the way if you have implemented TOC solution for replenishment. Now let us look at the second question. When should I change the buffer size? What is buffer size? The amount of quantity of any item that I would like to keep, say at retail store or with the distributor. How much should I keep? If I keep too much, it will not get sold. It will become obsolete. There will be excess. If I keep, if my buffer size is too low, I might lose sales. So this, how do I find the answer? The answer is simple. If the buffer level of a product remains in the red for 2 or 3 consecutive replenishment periods, it is a signal to increase the buffer level. Now, what does that mean? In TOC solution or replenishment, we recommend frequent replenishment. So you know that after every few days, you will be receiving some replenishment. But if you find that continuously between 2 or 3 replenishment periods, that level of quantity of inventory has been remained more or less in red. So it means your sales have really grown, or is it the stock that you're handling is not adequate? So it is a signal to you. Right? I'm saying it is a signal and not a decision, because you are there on the field. You know that you this particular month, this okay, there has been some extra sale. There's some special cause for this. It is not a permanent increase in the sale. No, it may happen that in one particular locality, there are too many birthdays in a particular month. So there is a lot of sale of chocolates, but it may not be a permanent increase in the sale. So despite being in red, you might decide not to increase. But typically, it is a call. It is a signal that the system has given to you. You, as a manager, take a call whether you want to increase the buffer level so that you don't lose the sales. If the buffer level for a product remains in green for two or three consecutive replenishment periods, it means your sales either have declined and you are not able to sell, or you are holding too much of a quantity. No demand. So in that case, either you make efforts to sell more, which may fetch some immediate results, or you reduce the buffer size, meaning the level of inventory that you want to keep at a particular shop or in your warehouse, you reduce that level. So what do you expect that, supposing you get a computerized output of all your products, what you should see that dominantly most of the products are in yellow zone for most of the time. If they are there, your stocks are okay. Few could go up and down from yellow to green, green to yellow to red, and up and down. That is expected to be normal, right? But the dominant color, if you take a snapshot of your entire product portfolio, you should find yellow color to be dominant one. If that is the case, your system is working fine. But now, what more you want? You are getting signal as to when to intervene, when to exploit it, when not to exploit it. You are getting signal whether you need to increase the buffer size or you need to decrease the buffer size. You are getting a signal that wait, don't take any action, everything is fine. What more management will want? So the system that TOC has given tells you precisely whether to intervene or not to intervene by setting up a very robust signaling system.